أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعة. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. أوكي، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد رسول رب العالمين، وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا أرحم الراحمين. والله teach us what benefit us. Increase us in knowledge, in good morals and in good deeds يا رب العالمين. We continue by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's blessings in this lesson explaining منظومة المقدمة فيما يجب على قارئ القرآن أن يعلمه من نظم إمام الحفاظ وحجة القراء محمد بن محمد بن محمد بن علي بن يوسف ابن الجزري رحمه الله تعالى. Who was born 751 and passed away 833 of the Hijra of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we are wrapping up section 10, أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. أحكام النون الساكنة والتنوين. And alhamdulillah, we finished إخفاء. We explained إخفاء, all the methods of إخفاء. And today, inshallah, we will go over the examples of إخفاء. The examples of إخفاء. So as we mentioned last time, the letters of ikhfa, the way to apply ikhfa, the general way is the first step. We're gonna pronounce the letter before the noon sakinah or tanween. And if we take this example, the easiest example I see is this mantha. So in this example, we say the meme ma, that's the letter before the noon sakinah or tanween, right? Ma, and then we're gonna prepare our organs of speech. We're gonna prepare them to pronounce the ikhfa letter. So we're not gonna touch the noon. We're not gonna touch the gum to pronounce a noon, because that will be an izhar. We're gonna say what? Ma. So instead of touching the gum, we have to move our tongue and our organs of speech and prepare them to pronounce the ikhfa letter. And while we are prepared, during this preparation time, there's a ghunna from the nose, a long ghunna going on. And once that long ghunna is over, we pronounce the ikhfa letter without any ghunna. Tamam? Man the. Now this preparation, we said, based on the way we read ikhfa with every letter and the way we apply ikhfa with every letter, I found that we can make them into three groups. The first group of letters, touch then press. The second, close then touch. And the third, close then closer. And we explained them in details before. And for normal students, for let's say beginners in tajweed, you can watch the easy tajweed playlist, and I explained that in short videos and every method in one video. And if you like also, inshallah, in this class also, it will be helpful, inshallah. So let's start with the first method. The first method, which is what? The first method is touch, then press. Means when I prepare my organs of speech to pronounce the ikhfa letter, that preparation happens by touching the organs of speech with each other. And once that long gunna is over, we press to pronounce the ikhfa letter. For example, or not for example, the letters we have here are val, tha, dha, val, tha, dha. Those Lithuania letters, Lithuania letters. And they're called Lithuania not because they come from the gum, but because they come close to the gum, which is what, like from the teeth. You place the tip of the tongue between the teeth or at the upper teeth. F, F, L, F, F, L, right? So F, F, L, Tha, 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 and Fa, Qaf, Kaf. Fa, Qaf, Kaf. Tamam? These are the six letters in which we apply this method. Yani, how do you apply ikhfa of the noon sakina or tanween at these six letters? How do you apply it? We apply it by touching the makhraj of those letters or touching the organs of speech, touching the organs of speech that are involved in pronouncing that letter. And once the long gunna is over, we press in order to, we press the organs of speech on each other in order to pronounce the ikhfa letter. Particularly with the thal and tha and dha, we touch the makhraj of the thal and tha and dha means we're going to touch the, we're going to place our tip of the tongue between the upper and lower teeth like this, okay? F, M, 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 okay? So that's what we mean by touching, right? We're touching the makhraj of the thal or the tha or the dha, okay? Like this. M, M, M. Anf, 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 anf. Okay, that's how we're touching. So what are we touching with what? Depends on the letter. Okay, depends on the letter. And once the long one is over, we're going to press. In the tha, thal, tha, we're going to press a little bit on the tip of the tongue to pronounce the tha and thal and tha. And man-va, and the fa, same thing, we're going to press a little bit on the lips. And the qaf, same thing, we're going to press a little bit on the soft palate with the root of the tongue, of the with the back part of the tongue. Okay, clear? See how I'm touching? In the qaf, the makhraj, as you can see, is completely blocked, huh? Then I press a little bit to pronounce the qaf. Same thing with the kaf. Same thing. Tamam?
This is touch and press. Bismillah. Let's read the examples. Any question before we move on? So that's how you do ikhfa. Any question? Okay. Bismillah. Let me keep the picture big and I'll just look at the examples here. And you don't have to see the examples, do you?
Yeah. So the first example we have here, Ali Munqadir. Okay. Ali Munqa. Here, I want you in all of these examples, so today will be basically examples. In all of these examples, and if anyone who's watching us have any question, please go ahead and ask. In all of these examples, make full haraka before the noon second or tanwin. Don't say Ali mo, no, mu, Ali, mu, and when you pronounce the The ghunna, the lips should be normal. You don't say Ali munqa. No, Ali munqa. Tamam? The lips should be normal during the ghunna because there's no haraka, there's sukoon. So full haraka and the lips normal. Ali munqa. The sound completely from the nose. Tamam? Not Ali mo, as some students do, or some teachers, or some, no. Not Ali mo, no, you have to block the makhraj. Touch well. Ali munqa. Tamam? Ali munqadir. The calf, same thing. Ink, huh? Ink, let's say man kana. The whole, there's no oral sound at all in qaf and kaf, only in these two letters. Yes, we're touching, but touching more than any other letter, and the makhraj completely closed. So there's only ghunna during the preparation time. There's only ghunna from the nose. Man kana. Tamam. And that's a very common mistake. So don't say man kana. That's not right at all. Mank, ink, minkum, man kana, minkum. And here a common mistake, especially with the kasra and with the waw, some people generate a letter. They generate a letter. They say, me, listen, huh? Me, e, you're adding ayah, ya akhi. Wallahi, there are people, they read like this. There are teachers, they teach like this. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So please pay attention. Not me, e, no sound from the mouth at all in this letter. Mink, ink, me, ink, mink, right away. Minkum, minkum. Minkum kuntum. We'll come to the ta. We'll talk about that in the ta. So that is the second example. Then we have in kuntum. We said in kuntum. We're going to come to the ta. Kalimatin fataba. Kalimatin fatab. As I mentioned again and again and again. We don't touch completely like this. Kalimatin. No, we don't leave complete gap like this. Kalimatin, as some many students do, and many teachers and some qurra who recite in those gatherings. Kalimatin, because they want to make more sound, they do that. That's wrong. Kalimatin, you touch lightly. So there will be a very tiny gap between the front teeth and the lip, but the other teeth touching the lip. As I showed you many times. Kalimatin fatab. That is the fa. Hudan fa. Ankum. Mi'unqa. Don't make a gap. Don't say mi'un. Don't make a gap. From the mim right away to the preparation on the qaf, to touch the qaf right away. Min qabil. Okay. What else? Man dha alladhi. Yeah. Man dha alladhi. What else? لا تنظرون and أنثى. لا تنظي. Touching. تنظي. Pressing. تنظرون. Okay. لا تنظرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. Okay. لا تنظرون. Wanted to say something, forgot. Okay, niswatun fi, unfa,
Okay, this is the method of touch then press. Touch then press. بارك الله فيك يا فداء. May Allah love you. That's it. Any question about this method, guys? People who are watching, people who are present here. طب يلا, who? I know Sister Asifa and Suha and Kuthum, you apply that correctly. Sister Halima, you want to read those examples?
Yes, Sister.
You have doubt in any example? Go ahead. Yalla, Bismillah. Read one example for each letter.
Okay. Alimu Qadir.
Again?
Alimu Qadir.
Right. The sound is not very clear, but it's correct.
إن كنتم.
Again.
إن كنتم.
Right.
كلمات فتاب.
Right.
هدى فمن تبع.
I'm afraid you're touching completely. Again.
فمن تبع.
No, هدى فمن.
هدى فمن.
هدى فأنف.
هدى ف.
So you should be able to see that tiny gap between the upper teeth and the lip. Okay?
Okay.
If you're not leaving that gap, this means you have to work on it. Okay.
هدى ف. هدى ف.
Okay. من ذا الذي.
من ذا الذي.
تنظرون.
لا تنظرون.
Make the ظاء heavy. That's what I wanted to remind you, that we don't need to say, okay, with the غنة in the light letters is light, in the heavy letters is heavy. Yes, that's correct. But if you apply and prepare the مخرج correctly to pronounce the letter, naturally the غنة will be heavy in the heavy letters and light in the light letters. Okay. Say it again. تنظري.
لا تنظرون.
Now make the ظاء heavy all the way.
Okay. لا تنظرون.
تنظي. لا
تنظي. تنظي.
ماشي. أنثى.
أنثى.
Say it.
أنثى.
Okay, barakallah. Anyone wants to practice? Anyone wants to practice? Okay. You all understand this method well? Okay, alhamdulillah. Tabiyal. Let's move to the next method. So the next method, as you can see in the screen, bring it close, then touch. We bring the tongue so close to the makhraj of the ikhfa' letter. And once the long gunna is over, we move it to the exact makhraj. Means we touch to the exact makhraj of the ikhfa letter by touching. This applies to delta, ta, bad, jim. Five letters. Delta, ta, bad, jim. Let's take the examples. So the first example, in taliqu. So here, we're going to pronounce e, e. That's the letter before the noon, sakina. E, now I prepare the makhraj to pronounce the ta. How? I bring the tongue close to the gum, right? I don't say im, If I touch, then I'm pronouncing the noon because the ta and the noon, they're close. That's why we don't apply touch then press. If we apply touch then press, then you're doing izhar. Right? Izhar with ghunna. Imta. That's wrong. So we're going to bring the tongue close, huh? See how? Got it? So we bring the tongue close, then we touch. And I don't need to make like, to say ghunna heavy. If you're preparing your tongue to do the ta, the ghunna will be heavy. Now when I say, you know that that's not a ta. So if I say
انطلقوا. That's absolutely wrong. We say you, we don't need to say you, you made the ghunna light. We said you did not prepare to do a ta. You prepared to do a ta. When you say in, I know you're going to say a dal or a ta. You're going to say intahu, right? So in, that's how you prepare for the ta. Not only from the front, you prepare the whole makhraj, the whole organs of speech, you prepare them to do the ta. So the ta is heavy, means you're going to curve your tongue from the middle. انطلقوا تمام من دونهم من دونهم من and here don't raise your don't say من don't close your lips من you should be able to see your lower teeth for the best pronunciation inshallah من دو من دو تمام من دونه يكون جا the tongue the middle part of the tongue close to the jim يكون ج يكون جا يكون جبارا يكون جا 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 يكون جبارا next example طعام ترزقاني طعام طعام ترزقاني عنده من تأويل من تأويل فصبر جميل فصبر جميل فصبر جميل وانتظروا وانتظروا موضود Mal, when I say the edges of the tongue close to the bod. Mal, last example. Kuntum, and here pay attention as I mentioned, كنتم we don't add كون don't add a wow كون right away كون right away كنتم توم not توم كنتم تمام what else وإياكم last example أنجينا أنجينا okay this is the second method any question طب يلا anyone has any doubt in applying this rule sister Halima you want to apply brother Asim يلا go ahead read for me one example quickly for each
طعام ترزقاني عنده
and here very important to pay attention guys sorry sister I have some ijaza students that's how they learned subhanallah يعني for a year I keep telling him this point until alhamdulillah finally he started like catching it okay when you learn something wrong and you read it for years, it's not easy to fix it right away. That's why, please, don't send your kids, guys, to any person. Don't put your kids just in any program. And you yourself, don't go and teach if you don't know the rules really well. Okay? Because this is responsibility. This is amana. And especially if you teach little kids. Subhanallah, some people, they just get any person to teach or... Just they put their child on the computer just from with someone from here or there, and just because they don't charge anything or they charge very little tuition or whatever. Don't worry about all these things. Worry about the quality. Worry about this person is qualified or not. Subhanallah. So don't we don't say عين, bring the tongue closer. عين ده. Continue.
من تأويل. فصبر جميل وانتظروا.
Read for me منضود.
منضود.
كنتم.
أنجينا.
Again.
أنجينا.
I feel you're touching, huh? Again.
أنجينا.
No. أنج.
أنجينا.
أنج. You're saying أنج. أنج. You're not touching. You should not touch.
Okay.
Close, then touch.
أنجينا.
Say أنج.
أنج.
Just say this. The way to know that you're doing it right or no, prolong the ghunna for me. Say inj.
Inj.
Say
inj.
No, prolong it more.
Okay.
Inj. Just for the sake of practice.
Okay. Inj.
You see, you're not being able to prolong it a lot because you're touching.
Yeah.
Look, huh? Yes.
Anjaina.
Okay, practice that. Okay, Brother Hasim.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa
rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yalla, bismillah, go ahead.
طعام ترزقاني.
So you're gonna round the lips really well. طعام مو
طعام طعام ترزقاني.
Say.
طعام ترزقاني.
Okay. عنده.
عنده.
Right. من ت انتظروا.
أنجينا.
Not أن light. أنجا.
أنجينا. أنجينا.
No, the first one was better. أنجا. The second last one you said.
أنجينا.
أنجا.
أنجا.
Okay, ماشي. بارك الله فيك. You need more practice. I need to see you. I need to see you and try to join the Mahri club,
yes,
so that I can
sure.
See you and you can read inshallah face to face and
Jazakala,
I help you.
Sure.
I see you need some improvement, Brother Asim. So but you have
definitely
the foundation, mashallah.
Thank
okay,
you.
Barakallah
so
fi. So bring it close, then closer. Now the last method, guys, this needs attention because here I why I said close then closer. We bring the organs of speech so close to the makhraj of the ikhfa letter. And once the long ghunna is over, we move to the exact makhraj of the ikhfa letter by bringing the organs of speech closer. Well, someone might say, okay, why don't you say, you said touch, then press, and then you said close, then touch. Why are you not saying no touching here? Of course, no touching. Why? Because this letter, the sheen, is the basic letter to understand this method, guys. The sheen is by bringing the tongue close, then closer. The sheen is pronounced by raising the middle part of the tongue close to the roof of the mouth. Ash. We never touch. Ash. So the ikhfa, you do it by bringing that middle part of the tongue close, then closer when the long ghinna is over. Tamam? That is why I call this method close, then closer. أنشأكم من شيء من شيء تمام. Now what about سين and صاد and زاي؟ سين and صاد and زاي, guys, all of them, they are pronounced this way. You're gonna rest the front part of your tongue at the lower incisors like this. And then you're gonna bring the teeth close, the upper and lower teeth close to each other, like this. And there's no touching. Look here, if you see the teeth, the upper and lower teeth are not touching. See, in all of them, there's no touching. That's why I call this method close, then closer. Okay, because you bring the teeth close, then closer. Minsa, milsa, minza, anza, ansa, ansa. Tamam? That is why we call it bring it close, then closer. So, because these letters, as you can see, they're not pronounced by connection between the organs of speech. Okay. Let's read the examples and then we are done, inshallah. We mentioned the main mistakes. And then we have the signs of idgham in the mushaf, etc. Okay, let's read the examples. Bismillah. Min sultan. I want to show you how you see the teeth are coming closer and closer. See this tiny distance. Min sultan, min su, anz. We don't touch. If we touch, it will be anz. No, anz. Okay, that is the this method. Yansurkum. ركن شديد ريحا صرصرا ريحا صرصرا ريحا صرصرا ليال سوية. Okay, so this is the method. Send me an email if you want to participate in this class. Send me an email to yourbrother01@gmail.com. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. So we're done with that. So here we said, this is because these letters, we said that, okay. And now the notes, note that the noon sakina is in green because there's ghunna to indicate the long ghunna and is stripped of the sukoon because there's ikhfa. Also notice that the harakat in the tanween are in green and are not exactly stacked above each other, right? Are not exactly stacked above each other, unlike the izhar. As you can see the harakat, they're not stacked like the izhar like that. No. Okay. A mistake to avoid, we mentioned some people put a break or barrier between the letter before the noon and the ikhfa letter by lengthening the haraka on the letter before the noon, turning it into a mad letter. Kuntum, antum, minkum. That's all wrong. We explained that. Notice also the noon sakina is in green to indicate the long ghunnah and is stripped of the noon sukoon. We said that already. Also the harakat in the tanween are in green and not exactly. We said that already, didn't we? So that's just a repetition, right? The noon sakina and is stripped of the, or here, what's that? The tanween. So here we're talking about the tanween. Was that the noon sakina is in green and is also that's the harakat in the tanween are in green. So this is just repetition. Okay. The examples, we read all examples, or we read many examples, the above picture. Okay. So now from the 8 rules that we have learned for noon sakina and tanween, we noticed that the ghunna
is four levels, longest ghunna, and we apply it when we have idgham shafawi, when we have two letters of ghunna or idgham shafawi or idgham with ghunna. The two letters of ghunna, of course, are noon with shadda and meem with shadda. The long ghunna we apply it when we have ikhfa shafawi and qalb, and the short ghunna is applied with idhar and idhar shafawi, which is the normal ghunna an'amta. And the shortest ghunna, if you like to learn about the shortest ghunna, that will be in any noon with haraka and meem with haraka. And the length of the ghunna can be learned correctly only from skillful licensed reciters. And they are not measured by harakat, not by the finger, not by the movement of the finger. They are measured, or they are learned from the licensed teachers. And they differ from one speed to another and from one type of reading to another. So we have a noon sakina and al-mim al-mudghamatan. They have longest ghunna. Al-mukhfatan, they have long ghunna. And that includes qalb. And al-mudharatan, they have short ghunna. And mutaharrikatan means when they have harakat, they have shortest ghunna. وأما الميم والنون فيتجافى بهما اللسان إلى موضع الغنة من غير قن من غير قيد من غير قيد. أيوة. Means in the noon and meem in إخفاء, the tongue doesn't go يتجافى بهما اللسان إلى موضع الغنة. It goes to the غنة. وبرهانه سد الأنف وهي في الساكن. أيوة. فيتجافى بهما اللسان إلى موضع الغنة من غير قيد. Mean he's talking about the noon and meem. Imam al-Dani, because someone asked me where we got these levels of ghunna. Imam al-Dani, he passed away 404, I think, after the hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Very ancient scholar, and he's in the Sanad and the Ijazat of Quran in many qiraat. So he's saying the proof of the ghunna is that when you close the nose, you will hear the ghunna. And then he's saying هي في الساكن أكمل منها أكمل من المتحرك. When the غنّة, when the noon is ساكنة, the غنّة is a little bit longer than when the noon has a حركة. And longer than نا ما. وفي المخفي أزيد منها من المظهر. When it is in إخفاء, أمب ربهم ب كنتم. That's in إخفاء. It is longer than إظهار. أنعم أنعم. It's shorter than كن. وفي المدغم أوفى من المخفي. And in the idgham, in is longer than antum, right? These are the ghunna. And we explained about the ghunna and the mistakes in the ghunna long time in the makharij of the letters and the sifat of the letters. Some people, they make it short. Some people, they make it long. You have to stick to that and learn it from the scholars. And you don't go in or kun. You go up and down or you bounce the ghunna. Ana, ana, ana. You don't do any of that. You don't bounce the noon. You don't bounce the ghunna. With this, we finished this section, inshallah. I hope I did not miss anything. Any question about anything we said today? Okay. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Salli lahumma wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And next, inshallah, will be the test. We're going to take the test on this section before we move to the med section, inshallah.